best X-Men movie yet? Possibly. So I am Zaven Weick, and I am joined here by
Alex Weiss from the future.
Yes.
To warn Zane that we are about to review X-Men Days of Future Past.
Yes, and he made his
this is my younger body, but it's my older self.
Yeah. And he made it his mission to make sure I review it today.
Yes. Or else he's gonna cause these giant mutant killer robots to happen.
So it's a pretty good...
Good supplement, yeah.
So, yeah, anyways, yes, X-Men Days of Future Past. Oh my gosh. I am glad I like X-Men these days. This movie it just surpassed all the other movies.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, in my opinion, so far, it's been the best X-Men movie.
I wholeheartedly agree, sir.
Okay. I mean, I actually would almost call it, like, X-Men-wise, I'd say this movie, First Class, and then possibly the first actual X-Men movie.
I'd say two after that.
Yeah. Well, either way, it's...
The original ones. We'll get to that later.
Yeah. So anyways, obviously this is a movie based on the famous comic Days of Future Past for the X-Men.
By Chris Claremont.
And I think there's been many versions done of it. I know there's the one main comic book one, but then there's been some cartoon versions of it where they changed.
Yeah, they did it on the cartoon. I don't know anything about that.
I've heard of it, but I don't
really know it. And then they teased the Sentinels in The Last Stand, but it was literally just a tease.
And then, of course, in the Wolverine at the end on the screen, you have Trask Industries.
Oh, yeah. That end credit scene was amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing. Probably the best part of the Wolverine.
Besides Wolverine.
Yeah, besides the Wolverine.
But anyways, so, yeah, we start out...
In the future,
yes. And
it's basically this huge, like, apocalyptic dystopian future where basically the Sentinels have taken control and they either have wiped out almost all the mutants or taken, like, them, like, captive, like, put them in concentration camps. And it's basically a dire situation. And then, like... It starts out in, like, China. Right? China? They go to China.
Yeah.
They go to China.
They go somewhere with some Chinese-style buildings.
Yeah. And then a group of X-Men, Blink, Sunspot, Iceman,
Kitty Pryde,
Bishop.
Storm.
Yeah, Storm. Yeah, Storm 2.
Not Storm. Yeah.
No.
In the future?
Not in the first time. No, not the first time.
Sure?
Yeah.
Because she was...
Well, she... Like, they had that big, awesome reveal of, like, the original four. Like, Magneto, Professor Xavier, Wolverine, and then Storm.
Yeah.
It's just, like, the younger group of X-Men.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And Colossus.
Okay.
And Colossus.
Yeah.
We're all holed up.
Gotcha.
And I think it's Warpath spots him. Spots out the Sentinels saying, like, they're here, and they're coming, stuff like that, so they get ready for battle. And, like, they show up, it's basically like an Avengers-type thing, where they have, like, the cool, like, panorama shot of all of them, like, powering up, and then, like, the Sentinels come. And these guys are dangerous, man. They are just insane.
And we'll get to why they are a little later on, because...
Like, we see, basically... Iceman's head get, like, melted off and then, like, crushed. We see Blink get stabbed through her own, like, teleport powers.
From three different directions.
Yeah, from three directions. Yeah, it's a really cool sequence. Like, great opening, good setup.
Now, the one thing I do want to touch on in the beginning, and I mean, this was kind of hinted at the end of Wolverine, Professor X and Magneto working together,
What is going on? This is weird.
It's like these two have been enemies in most of the X-Men movies, and now they're just deciding to actually join up when they have been enemies this whole time. Honestly, you know, I was kind of glad they finally did.
Yeah.
Because it's like, okay.
Well, I'm glad Magneto didn't have, like, I told you so moment. Well, maybe, like, towards, like, in the past future and stuff like that, like, a few years after the Sentinels started happening, maybe he started doing that.
Yeah.
And then they got over it. It's like, okay, we gotta stop this. And, like, the only way to stop this future from happening is by sending somebody back to 1973 from killing the Sentinels' creator, Bulwer Trask, in public.
Well, but that wasn't actually even really the main issue. The reason they had to go back and was to actually stop Mystique
from killing Trask.
No, not really that. From just her getting hit by
she killed Trask and then she got caught and then they started making the Sentinels.
Yeah, so they have to go back basically to stop that from happening. Wolverine says, you know, how about you send me back? Because apparently, whenever you send someone back in time, their mind will either explode or something.
Yeah, Kitty Pryde was only able to do maybe a few weeks with Bishop or somebody else. But this is like a whole nother level. Sending your mind back 50 years would pretty much just like...
And of course Wolverine has a healing factor.
Yeah, so it doesn't really matter for
so...
him. And it'll look the same age.
So yeah.
Much, except without the gray hair.
Yes.
Gray hair.
So he sent back and he sent back to 1973, right?
Yeah.
And so he's on this mission to find, of course, Xavier and Magneto.
Xavier first.
So yeah, but he starts out with Xavier. Goes to the school, because of course he knows where it is, because he's from the future.
Mm-hmm. And it's all torn down and worn down. All the people that is left is Hank McCoy and Professor Xavier, who is just...
He's a real bum.
Yeah, he's down, because this is like during Vietnam, like the height, well, not the height of Vietnam, but during the Vietnam War, all the students left got either drafted or just went away. And now, Xavier is just a poor guy. He's just, like, he can walk now for some reason. But...
Well, yeah.
Yeah, he's been taking this, like, mutant cure... Well, this cure for his spine from, like, Hank's, like, thing that helps him, like, block out his, like, mutation and stuff so he can be human. But it's costing him his powers.
Yeah, which... Yeah. I mean...
It's sad.
It's sad,
but like, Wolverine has to play the teacher role now.
Yeah.
You have to be like his Xavier at this moment. And it's like nice character development for Wolverine.
Yeah. And I mean, when Wolverine does actually, like, he literally does show up to the mansion and he knocks, Hank enters and he's like, Are you Beast?
You're scrawny for a little kid. Like, you're scrawny, man. Where's the Beast?
And of course, at first, the Beast is like, or Hank's like, you shouldn't be here. And he's like, well, I gotta talk to the professor, so...
There's no professor here.
And then, of course, he goes looking, Wolverine goes looking on.
You and I are gonna be good friends. You just don't know yet.
And Hank finds that a little insulting, and he goes full out and takes down Wolverine until... They happen to come across Professor X sitting on, not so much sitting, more slacking on the couch, kind of, you know, he kind of looks like he's high.
Yeah, he's out of it.
He's there, but he's not there.
So he tries to explain to Xavier what the situation is, and that, like, they need to go find Magneto. And he's just like, that's what makes him kind of like snap. It's just like, no, you don't want to work with this guy. He's a monster now. So they go off to meet this really odd character in Quicksilver.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, it's one of the best parts of the film.
A lot of people before were saying,
Quicksilver looks stupid.
He looks stupid. He's going to be like the worst part of the film. No.
No.
He was the freaking best part of the film.
Show stealer.
We'll get to it, the scene that he does steal the show up, but I mean, just even before that, just the fact that he's being a smart aleck,
yeah.
Wolverine and yeah. all that, is like, you want to break someone out of prison?
That's illegal, you know.
Yeah, not if I get caught, though. He's like, okay.
And then, like, he shows him his mutation. That's cool, but it's disgusting.
Yeah. So, they somehow end up, and I think, didn't Logan say that they were actually, like, they were kind of friends?
Yeah, in the future.
Wow. Or didn't he say,
he knows a guy.
Yeah, he knew. So he knew him somehow.
Yeah.
Because he actually knew his real name, too. So.
Yeah. Petrol.
Yeah, something like that.
Petrol.
So they talk Quicksilver into helping them spring Eric, aka Magneto.
Out of the Pentagon. And this just awesome,
oh my gosh.
Slow motion, like Quicksilver just like running on the walls and listening to Time in a Bottle. And he's just causing havoc, and like it's all in slow motion, so it's like everything's just like slow. But he's moving at, like, regular speed.
Yeah.
Well, super speed. And, like, he's just, like, pointing the bullets to different directions. He's punching people in the face. Like, he's, like, tasting the food and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. And, yeah.
And, like, and it's funny. It's, like, he had to get one of, like, the police uniforms. He's just waiting in the elevator for him. And then, like, it just cuts to him, like, unrolling some tape. We don't see that.
No, but we know that happened.
Yeah.
But yeah, so he gets on top of
I'll be right back.
Of Magneto's cage. And he's like
shaking the glass.
Yeah.
At first
he gave Magneto his mail.
Oh,
like,
yeah,
he
yeah.
said, mind the glass.
The glass.
He's like, mind the glass. He looks up and sees the game. He's like, hey, how's it going?
and the glass
breaks, and he's like, "Well, come on! I didn't break you up for nothing."
Mind your head. Why? Whiplash. What? Whiplash.
And he's like, "You realize when that door opens, there are gonna be tons of guards. Oh, I can get past them. How can you get past them? I can get past them." And the door, all the doors open. He's like, and he's right, he's like,
yeah,
like that. So,
and then, like, after they break out Magneto, they're on this plane, and, like, this is where, this is the first time they've talked in, like, 10 years. Xavier and Eric.
And it's a very well-done scene.
Yeah.
Because I think it was really the time where, you know what, we've had these emotions build up for so long that we have to just get these out now.
Yeah, like... Xavier starts to blame Magneto for what happened, and then Magneto's just like, no, it's the other way around. You were supposed to protect them. You abandoned us all.
Yeah.
Because, like, you started, like, taking the cure and, like, giving up.
Well, no, because he didn't know, before he said that, he didn't know that Xavier took the cure.
And no, it was after that.
Yeah. Well, anyways, he was
it's
like...
It's been a while since we've seen that.
Yeah. But, yeah, so it gets tense, and he's like, you abandoned all of us.
And then, like, Wolverine, like, kind of, like, talks to him later. It's just like, you know, we're pretty much enemies in the future. And then, like, he was like, oh, really? Magneto was, and then, like, Wolverine, after he kind of rocks the plane, it's just like, are you going to clean that shit up?
Yeah.
It's just, like, he's so good. Wolverine is actually really, like, he's basically the main character in every X-Men movie, but here, he kind of deserves.
Oh.
Well, except for First Class, he's the main character.
Yeah, first class, he just made a cameo.
Yeah, awesome cameo.
Which they do reference back in this movie.
Okay, we gotta keep this kind of short, okay?
I know.
Okay, okay, after that, they have to stop Mystique from killing Trask at the peace conference in Paris. And then it goes pretty much to hell and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like,
well, they do stop her.
Yeah, but Magneto kind of just like thinks like, oh, if they're gonna capture her and like take her blood, might as well just take her out here. And like he starts pointing the blade
the
bullet towards her, and it's just like, I'm so sorry, Mystique. And then like she goes out the window, and then like the bullet just like follows her and hits her and stuff.
Yeah.
And back into the future, actually in the past, Wolverine recognizes Stryker, the early version of Stryker, and he freaks out in the future. It's just like, and scratches Kitty Pryde, and then like for a split minute or two, he's kind of just like confused as how like he doesn't even know who Beast is. He doesn't know who Xavier is, but then like he calms down and then he comes back.
Yeah.
And like just that freak out moment.
And so after that, it's kind of okay.
The public has seen these mutants and stuff like that. So Trask uses that to get the okay to start the Sentinel program.
Yeah.
And in the future, Xavier explains that, oh, I think we've made matters worse for each other. It's even worse. In this future.
And so, yeah, basically, so Magneto leaves, Mystique leaves, and Hank, Wolverine, and Xavier have to go back to the mansion. They find Mystique, they tell her that she needs to turn over to their side. Well, off to the side, Magneto is going back to retrieve his old helmet and uniform.
Yeah, with the two metal balls in it.
Yeah. So that happens. Oliver Trask gets to present his new Sentinels to the press, with the president introducing it.
Yeah.
And of course, beforehand, Magneto
sneaks in some metal into it because, like, they made them basically like plastic, right?
Yeah. So
some kind of
they couldn't be controlled by him. And of course, that metal was used, and Magneto turns the Sentinels against everybody, which brings back Wolverine, Xavier, and Hank.
Well, we forgot to mention that he lifts an entire baseball stadium to keep everybody in.
Well, yeah. And keep people out.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, Mystique is actually up there at the same time.
Disguised as one of his, like, bodyguards, right?
Yeah.
Or advisors.
So. Well, at one point, she actually does impersonate the president himself.
Yeah.
But
yeah. That's later.
Yeah. So, yeah, Xavier and them
It all comes down to, basically, Magneto rips out the bunker of the White House and, like, brings it in. And then, does she knock out Magneto? No, she knocks out Magneto before. Like, it all comes down to, like, Mystique, like, pointing the gun at Trask. And it's kind of like, it's a little bit cliche, but it's just like the deciding moment. And in the future, the Sentinels are closing in on, like, Storm is dead, Bishop's dead, Iceman's dead, Colossus is
dead,
pretty much. And they're going to be doomed if they don't do this right now. And then, like, Mystique puts the gun down and doesn't shoot Trask, and then it just goes blank. The future that we've been seeing so far goes blank.
But she does actually shoot Magneto at one point, so
and takes his helmet.
Yeah, so Xavier can take over again.
But somebody's missing, and that's Wolverine.
Well, that's because Magneto before had used some metal that was laying around, and he swerved it through Wolverine's body.
And he goes, you're right, we're survivors. And just, like, tosses him to the, what's the river in, what's the...
River.
The reflecting pool in DC. No, it wasn't that.
It was like ocean.
Yeah. It was like the ocean or something like that.
And, yeah, so...
And then we cut to this very different future where the school is reopened, Beast is still alive, Rogue and Iceman are together, and they're teaching classes, and Wolverine was like, what's going on? Because he would be the only one that would remember what happened before.
Well, actually, that's not... That is true, but at the same time, it's you're missing one part of that.
Like,
Xavier does still remember
kinda
that.
Kind of knows, yeah.
Because
he's Professor Xavier.
Yeah.
Professor X.
And so, yeah, of course we got Jean Grey back.
Yeah, yeah, that's a huge reveal.
Whatever.
We have our own redhead over here. Come on over.
Come join us, redhead.
Like...
Hi, I fell asleep during the movie because I was really, really tired. I don't...
What are we reviewing today?
We're reviewing X-Men's...
No, I think we're reviewing Doctor Who.
Oh, we are? Which one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Anyways, yeah, everything
is happy...
Happy ending, I guess.
Yeah, very happy ending.
And then, end credits scene.
Oh my gosh! No, we forgot that Mystique is impersonating Stryker.
Oh, yeah. And
so
she rescues the Wolverine in the past.
Wolverine, yeah.
And I don't know if she's the one that administers the Elementium back into him, or... Because he did have that in the future,
well,
but of course...
Well, we don't know that.
I know that. So...
I'm pretty sure he does.
I think he does have him back, but... but yeah, so she does that, and then...
Yeah, so,
and then, of course, the end credits scene, you have...
We flash back to ancient Egypt, and somebody is building the pyramids.
Who is it?
Apocalypse.
And
Sabah Nor. It's just a little kid with his hands up.
Yeah.
It's just like, what the hell is that?
And you turn slightly over...
And it's the Four Horsemen.
The Four Horsemen of Apocalypse.
Yeah.
So, there was one thing... that I'll briefly touch on that we forgot, and it was when Wolverine went through the metal detector.
Oh yeah!
it didn't go off.
They had so many good jokes because like the first time he goes back to the past, like he's sleeping with this woman and it turns out to be like this like monster's daughter or something like that. And it's just like he threatens them and it's just like, with what? Those packs and stuff like that. No, with these, and then he releases them, and there's bone closers. Just like, huh? And he just starts kicking their ass.
Yeah.
And then like at the presidential press conference thing, like he goes through a metal detector, and it doesn't go off. And it's just like,
okay.
And that was kind of fun.
Yeah.
It was fun, but serious as well.
Oh yeah. So.
What would you give it, Peggy? Out of five.
Out of five stars.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm going to give it 4.5 because, yes, it was a very good movie, but it was nowhere near a Guardians of the Galaxy for me.
Oh, you have to compare it to Guardians of the Galaxy.
You can't compare everything to Guardians of the Galaxy.
There's our redhead again.
I'm just saying, you can't compare everything to the Galaxy.
But no,
but
in all honesty, no. This, to me, I felt was the very best X-Men movie they have come out with yet. And, you know,
we have to say that basically all the X-Men movies that are not X-Men First Class and Days of Future Past don't matter. They don't matter.
Forget about them. Really, all you have to watch for this movie, honestly, is First Class. I mean,
yeah,
honestly,
pretty much First Class.
You just
gotta
watch First Class.
Yeah, it's awesome.
So, yeah, 4.5, because I love the story, I love the actors, I love Bryan Singer directing this one.
Yeah.
He's perfect for the franchise.
Yeah, he's coming back for Apocalypse.
Yeah, so 4.5 for me.
I have to go 5.
Okay, I mean, that's understandable.
Yeah, experience watching it and stuff like that, it's just a great time at the movies, stuff like that, and they got the tone right, and, like, just the right amount of humor, while still being, like, the stakes were pretty high, you understood the stakes, and the whole time travel thing was really cool, like, the whole freak out thing and stuff like that, like, with Wolverine, and Quicksilver.
Which I believe he is returning.
Yes,
so,
yes.
So yeah.
And I liked how they tied in Mystique. Even though Jennifer Lawrence's star has risen a lot,
yeah.
It seemed organic and it made sense. And the Sentinels were pretty cool.
Yeah.
And I want to see the next one. So
yeah.
Yeah.
So
it's been a really good year for Marvel.
It has been. Oh.
Except for one flat tire.
Which one are you speaking of? Are you speaking of the Sony one?
Yeah, that Sony.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. So yeah, that is our review for X-Men: Days of Future Past. I don't know which movie we're doing next. We'll probably.
It's a surprise.
It's a surprise.
Let's not do a Marvel movie. Let's switch it up.
We may switch it up.
Yeah.
You'll never see
it coming.
So, if you guys actually watch this review, please, 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 in the comments below, give us some ideas of what movies we should review.
Let's do a bad one.
We should review bad movies.
Voice of Ginger.
I'm just saying. We should review bad movies.
You thought we were reviewing Doctor Who tonight.
I have no idea what's going on.
Okay, cool.
I have my voice off to the side.
So, anyways, yes. So comment below what movies you think.
And subscribe to my channel.
My channel as well, and the Ginger.
There's
going to
be something coming within the next week. I know that I only have like 4 videos up, but there's going to be a fifth. There is another.
It's coming.
Yeah, it's coming very soon.
So, until next time, guys. See ya.
All right, see ya, bub.
Hi, I'm Connor. I think we were supposed to review X-Men Days of Future Past, but I apparently am early and or late.
Connor!
So, hey,
Connor!
What's
hey,
up?
Dude,
hey.
What are you doing here?
Yeah, what are you doing here?
I have no idea.
We've already reviewed Doctor Who.
Yeah.
Oh, we did?
No.
Wait.
We're reviewing Doctor Who right now.
Oh, yeah.
Sweet, which one?
Yeah,
Kill the Moon.
Oh, okay.
What'd you think, man? What'd you think?
I think it's 7.5.
No, 7. I'll go with 7.
No.
Okay.
Okay.
Good job,
Louis Coleman. Yeah, okay.
Yep.
Okay.
We'll see
you.
We'll see
you. You have fun with that. Good luck with the review, and good wishes, and hopefully people.
Wait, you're not helping?
Yeah, okay.
No, solo thing.
No, I can't do this. I'm not a film major.
You got this.
I can't do this.
You can do this, man.